Oh, isn't that just great, ladies and gentlemen? But wait a minute. We've got something else I just know you're going to love.
Coming right up, the Vocational Guidance Counselor sketch.
Vocational Guidance Counselor.
Vocational Guidance Counselor.
Vocational Guidance Counselor.
Ah, Mr. Angerville. Do sit down.
Thank you. Take the weight off the feet, eh?
Yes.
Lovely weather for the time of year, I must say.
Enough of this gay banter. And now, Mr. Angerville, you asked us to advise you which job in life you were best suited for.
That is correct, yes.
Well, I now have the results here of the interviews and the aptitude test that you took last week, and from them we've built up a pretty clear picture of the sort of person that you are. And I think I can say without fear of contradiction that the ideal job for you is chartered accountancy.
But I am a chartered accountant.
Very good. Well, back to the office with you, then.
No. You don't understand. I've been a chartered accountant for the last 20 years. I want a new job. Something exciting that will let me live.
Well, chartered accountancy is rather exciting, isn't it?
Exciting? No, it's not. It's dull. 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 My God, it's dull. It's so desperately dull and tedious and stuffy and boring and desperately dull.
Well, yes, Mr. Angerville, but you see, your report here says that you are an extremely dull person. You see, our experts describe you as an appallingly dull fellow, unimaginative, timid, lacking in initiative, spineless, easily dominated, no sense of humour, tedious company, and irrepressibly drab and awful. And whereas in most professions these would be considerable drawbacks, in chartered accountancy, they're a positive boon.
Don't you see, I came here to find a new job, a new life, a new meaning to my existence. Can't you help me?
Well, do you have any idea of what you want to do?
Yes. Yes, I have.
What?
Lion taming!
Yes. Of course, it's a bit of a jump, isn't it? I mean, chartered accountancy to lion taming in one go. You don't think it might be better if you worked your way towards lion taming, say, via banking?
No, I don't want to wait. But 9 o'clock tomorrow, I want to be in there, taming.
Fine. But do you have any qualifications?
Yes, I've got a hat.
A hat?
Yes, a hat, a lion taming hat, a hat with lion tamer on it. I got it at Harrods. And it lights up saying lion tamer in great big neon letters so you can tame them after dark when they're less stroppy.
I see.
And you can claim reasonable wear and tear, switch it off during the daytime, claim reasonable wear and tear as allowable professional expenses under paragraph 335B.
Yes, I do follow, Mr. Angerville, but you see, the snag is, if I now call Mr. Chipperfield and say to him, look here, I've got a 45-year-old chartered accountant with me who wants to become a lion tamer. His first question is not going to be, does he have his own hat? He's going to ask what sort of experience you've had with lions.
Well, I've seen them at the zoo.
Good.
Yes, the brown furry things with short stumpy legs and great long noses. I don't know what the fuss is about. I could tame one of those. They look pretty tame to start with.
And these lions, how high are they?
Well, we're about so high, you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They don't frighten me at all.
Really? And do these lions eat ants?
Yes, that's right.
Mm-hmm. Well, Mr. Angerville, I'm afraid what you've got hold of there is an anteater.
A what?
An anteater, not a lion. You see, a lion is a huge, savage beast, about 5 feet high, 10 feet long, weighing about 400 pounds, running 40 miles an hour, with masses of sharp, pointed teeth and nasty, long, razor-sharp claws that could rip your belly open before you could see Eric Robinson. And they look like this. Time enough, I think, for a piece of wood.
The lodge.
Now, shall I call Mr. Chipperfield?
No. I think your idea of making the transition to lion taming via easy stages, say via insurance or...
Banking, yes.
Yes, banking, that's a man's life, isn't it? Banking! Travel, excitement, adventure, thrills, decisions affecting people's lives!
Jolly good. Well, shall I put you in touch with the bank?
Yes.
Fine.
No. Look, big decision. I'd like just a couple of weeks to think about it. I don't want to jump into it too quickly. Well, maybe 3 weeks. I could let you know definitely then. I just don't want to make this definite decision.
This is just one of the all too many cases on our books of chartered accountants. The only way that we can fight this terrible, debilitating social disease is by informing the general public of its consequences. By showing young people...
Perhaps I could do it just for a bit, just for a week, and then...
that it's just not worth it. So please give generously to this address, the League for Fighting Chartered Accountancy, 55 Lincoln House, Basel Street, London, SW3.